Hello everybody, Big Mike Phantasm One. So I'm gonna do another review because I was taking a break for by a review since in the summer. So I'm gonna review Jonah Apatow's movie. Before I started this review, if you wanna go check out my IMDb walkthrough videos, go check it out. And I just have to say this film is okay in my opinion. So we'll talk about this during a time. There was also a DVD released by Universal coming December as of this month. So I'm just gonna go and explain of how many times that were so many annoying songs are that were and then the some of the parts are just an okay. I'm just gonna go and give it some rating right after, well, during of this review. So I'll see you in a second. So the movie begins in Jonah, where Bob Jr.'s dad and the Veggie Kids Jr., Laura, Annie, and Percy P are going out for see a Twibble, and Bob's driving with his van. So basically, with the first musical number, and which you can tell is part of like a childhood, but it's basically for kids and family. So this is a kids and family film, so let's not worry about this one. This is where it starts. So the musical number of the first song you hear, Laura losing her ticket because of like event starts. So I mean it's already starting. So yeah, she losing her ticket. But I realize that Junior's father freaking hitting his guitar on him. So basically, when the guitar made it a tire broken and the van keeps swerving, and so there was a porcupine problem, in which I couldn't tell.
Well, but nobody got hurt.
So yeah, when Bob had an injury, they realized that they found a seafood restaurant, so basically wants to stay there. So yeah, Junior and Laura having an argument, and then all of them are inside the restaurant until they realize that French fries are worked on the sushi. Are you serious?
May we help you?
When Bob tells of what's happening, there was a river scene to Shrek, which you can see right now.
And an angry mother porcupine shot out our tires, and one of her babies got me.
As you can tell, that there was a difference between this and Shrek. So let's put again.
Our tires, and one of her babies got me.
There's an arrow in your butt.
What?
And once, like when you see it right now, when any Junior's dad and Percy P are saying about, oh, I'm gonna do something. There was a music number again, which is a second shrimp.
Steak, steak, eat it, shrimp, shrimp, need it, steak and shrimp, need to, eat it, clever peen,
When Bob, Laura, and Junior are hearing and behind, they're just only pirates to do anything. So yeah, three of them are appearing in this movie, and it tries to tell the story of Jonah, so you can tell right now. So the story begins when pirates itself before Jonah appears.
We need more Mr. Twisty's Twisted Cheese Curls.
Yeah, and root beer.
I told you boys, no more cheese curls until you pay your tab. You still owe me from last week.
But you'll take away our chance to win the Mr. Twisty's Twisted Cheese Curl sweepstakes.
Come again?
Inside one of those bags of cheesy goodness is a golden ticket that'll change our lives forever.
Pause. Hargrave, you should not be at River Scene to Pole Express just before. Ugh, I can't tell. So anyway, when pirates are going somewhere, but it got stopped by Jonah, played by Archibald Fergus. So basically, it tries to tell one of the people from places where I don't know which one it was, but you tell about message from the Lord.
Dear people, I bring you a message from the Lord. Oh, it's a message of encouragement.
Then there was a musical number. The song alone here is just fine. Yeah, I'm just gonna go ahead and skip. And so, Jonah realized that Nineveh is a very bad place because her fish slaps, and which is made it worse. But I think it was kind of funny. Technically, when the scene, the whole of the animated, it was the non-Disney hand-drawn into like a different studios would work on a hand-drawn as well. So yeah, it's technically a decent scene. And once again, the musical number once more.
No, no,
no,
no.
Lol. Yeah, Jonah's running. So after Jonah hits a sign, Scooter comes out of nowhere, scaring. So this is the scene, in my opinion. Did kind of scare me when I was a kid. It's just like a jump scare, and that's the one, which is scared I was a kid. So, as you can tell, it points out of like a map, for example, and it's where like there was a star over here.
Oh, hello, Mr. Jonah. What's the word?
He's gone to Nineveh.
Oh, really?
So this is where when pirates sail. On the ship. So basically when Jonah about going to a place which I don't get what Larry says, but yeah. So each one of those pirates appeared of the second film, which I'm not into for now, but I'm just only reviewing on Jonah, so yeah, that's the one. So yeah, Jonah meets Khalil, and because of what he's doing while he's resting, he's tried to have his own joke and conversation, you know, and get kind of like tired. Which is basically the scene, in my opinion, is just also decent, but I don't see why also not when. So if you look at him, he's kind of look like a guy from Aladdin, which I couldn't tell what. He looks like so this is where he discovers how he met Jonah, so he doesn't explain why. Also,
that will break the back of the camel thief, but in the process will break the heart of the woman you love.
Oh brother, this guy stinks.
So the next scene is kind of baffles me. When there was a sort of copy of a dream sequences as the others.
It's you, Lord. I'm going.
This one, in my opinion, is copied from the other dream sequences. But why? So I think these three are a lot better than this. So yeah, this is where like it's about to jump. So this is the reason why this movie is alright, because there were only two scenes that were just sort of a side looking because of himself, Jonah, and Lord, which is basically unusual mediocre scenes, which I mean this part, you know, that's why I was giving you guys my thoughts of this one. So it just and so to speed the parts. Jonah and Khalil are inside in Wales with once again the musical numbers, which why.
So God told the whale to poif up Jonah, and Jonah got his second chance. And just like he promised, he headed straight for Nineveh.
Thanks for the tip. I forgot since what I was about to say is that both of them are going to Nineveh to send out a message. And this is more like walking through a desert, and it's just like the hottest place in the world. The guards tries to tell Jonah to leave because he doesn't want to get fish slapping and himself. But I just don't think that it would be good enough, but I don't know. Oh, by the way, the hat swap and each other, which why? And so the pirates are trying to let Jonah in to send a message, but basically there's just one problem according to that. There are thieves and basically try to arrest one of the pirates, and Jonah's telling the truth of he's with them. The unfair scene that there were like smashing pumpkins, it was just really sad scene. So after the message scene, then there was a next scene where Jonah is about to wait for Nineveh to destroy, and it doesn't explains why it shouldn't be destroyed, which I don't know. So after the Jonah story, the story was done, and so Twibble comes in into a restaurant, and there he is. And so Junior gives her his ticket, and so for this one, you know, this is what Twibble says.
Speaking of mercy, have any of you heard the story of a man named Jonah?
Then once again, a musical number, and I'm about to change music. It goes like,
out there, there's a world outside of Yonkers, way out there beyond this hick town, Barnaby. There's a slick town, Barnaby.
So after a musical number called Jonah Was a Prophet, then everybody comes in by cheering, and Khalil comes out of nowhere as a truck repairman. Like, why? Why is he in here? I mean, why would they throw out the story? So yeah, this is what everyone says. So, and there we go, folks. The Joan review. So basically, this film is alright. So, the another okay film. The others were Lilo and Stitch, Prince of Frog, Joker, and Venom. This film, and along with the visual series, are just changing my opinion since 4 years. So the reason why I started hate in 5 years because of close up and anything like that, because the songs are just annoying and side looking and stuff. So yeah, it's not pretty great. So it's alright. So what is your thought of this film? So let me know how it goes and. So like I said, it's just alright. So thank you guys so much for watching for my Jonah review. So see you guys then. Bye.